My name is Faris and this is Animated Anatomy. Now, I want to do something different now, and I want to make it in 3D. So I'm going to explain you the cerebellum anatomy in 3D, and it's not really hard, and there's not much new to learn, but it's really good for the orientation for you to understand what I will be talking about. So let's start with it. The cerebellum is located at the bottom of the brain, with a large mass of the cerebral cortex above it and the portion of the brainstem called the pons in front of it. Now, before we get into details, I want to say that on gross inspection, three lobes can be distinguished in the cerebellum. The flocculonodular lobe right here, and then we have the primary fissure. And if I create the sagittal section of the cerebellum, you can find the primary fissure somewhere over here. And everything behind the primary fissure and below is the posterior lobe, and everything here would be the anterior lobe of the cerebellum. So now you probably have no idea from which perspective are we looking at the cerebellum, especially if you're watching this video for the first time. Well, we're looking at the cerebellum from the ventral point of view. This is the cranial point of view, and here we're looking at it from the inferior point of view. So right now we are in front of the cerebellum. Now, I want to teach you about the details of the anatomy of cerebellum, but as you can see, this model is not really good. But don't worry, because I have illustrated it all for you. So this over here is the pedunculi of the flocculus. Now, as we draw step by step, it may not make sense immediately, but after we draw the complete cerebellum, it will make more sense. So here, this is the flocculus. So we have the pedunculi of flocculus, and we have the flocculus over here. Then we have the cerebellar pedunculi, vellum, and the pedunculi. They create the borders of the fourth ventricle. The fourth ventricle is the space over here. It's more like a bag, and it's filled with a cerebrospinal fluid. The vellum creates the roof of this fourth ventricle. The superior pedunculi creates also here the roof, but as we go further and closer to the medulla oblongata, it goes more lateral, so it creates the upper lateral border of the fourth ventricle. If this doesn't make sense, just imagine that pedunculi do not end here. This is a cut, we made a cut here. But they continue and they connect with the medulla oblongata, with the spinal cord. They send fibers and they receive fibers. Those are the bundles of nerve fibers that we have cut. For example, the fibers that carry information from cerebellum to the midbrain, they go through the superior one. The middle one contains usually the fibers coming from the nuclei of the pons, and they end in the cerebellar cortex. Those fibers group in superior, inferior, and deep ones. We will talk about that later. The inferior one connects the cerebellum with the spinal cord and medulla oblongata. Let's draw further. This over here is the uvula, and this over here is the pyramid of the vermis. Now, vermis, let me draw the complete vermis. All this is vermis. Up there, we have the central lobe, and we have the lingula of the cerebellum. All that belongs to vermis. Now, beside vermis, there are also two hemispheres, the left one and the right one. Let's draw them. Okay, so these are the part of the hemispheres above the horizontal fissure. So this is over here, would be horizontal fissure. Also, we have parts of hemisphere below the horizontal fissure. On these parts of hemisphere, we can notice the tonsilla here and the vallecula over here. Vallecula is just this space over here. If you can remember, this border over here, this part
was called the pyramid of the vermis, and the lateral border are the tonsilla of the cerebellum. Now with a little bit of Photoshop, this is how it looks like.
We should now look at the cerebellum from the dorsal and the caudal point of view.